Defense! Defense! Defense!
for two more.
At this time, to present the championship trophy to the captains, we have with us Bob Stebbings. He's the single A representative from the BC Boys Basketball Association. So we welcome him here. Let's give him a round of applause.
Thank you.
The number one team in the BC Provincial Final. Same class, please come on up.
What? We had alumni who had graduated recently and who who had graduated 15 years ago, who had found out we were playing in the provincial champions and said we had to come out and be part of it. And Langley took one step back and said, whoa, where have they all come from? And we earned tremendous respect for this community because we showed how good we really, really are. And you know what? We need a round of applause for everyone. The second part of this, of course, is the basketball itself, which these fine young gentlemen played very, very well in. Coach Knapp said to me, can you do me a favor and can you try to explain to the student body the fourth game? I said, okay, I'll see what I can do for you. So it went something like this. The first half ended 31-28 for us. We played very poorly. They played very, very well. So both teams walked off the floor. I turned to Mr. Hancock and I said, you know what? I'd love to be a fly on the wall in our dressing room just to hear what Knapp's going to say to them, because we probably wouldn't be able to repeat it anyway. But that's the way things are in sports. Houston Wildcats walked in ecstatic. We walked in very disappointed because we didn't play the way we did. Well, whatever Coach Santos said to them, the seniors took to heart. And the first 2 minutes of the third quarter went something like this. The ball goes to Houston Christian, they take the ball, inbounds and take a shot, miss, rebound, come down the floor, Julie takes the ball, at the top of the three-point line, bam, is a three-pointer. Houston inbounds the ball, comes down the floor, makes two passes, shoots, misses, Paula gets a rebound, outlet pass. Julie gets the ball, comes down the other side of the three-point line, bam, is another three-pointer. Houston takes the ball. Dizon to Julio, Julio on the other side of the court, bam, another three-pointer. Houston takes the ball, inbounds it again, comes down the floor, shoots, misses, rebounds, same pass, outlet to Julio, top of the line, boom, another three-pointer, 4-1, a three-point lead turned into a 16-point lead in a minute and a half. Mr. Hancock and I said the Blue game set, match point. Not so. We now fast forward 2 minutes, 35 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Celtics up by 10. Celtics shoot, miss. Houston grabs rebound, shoot, scores. Down by 8. Celtics take the ball on the floor, shoot, score. Miss, excuse me. We miss, they rebound, come on the floor, shoot, score. Down by 6. Mr. Hancock turns to me, I turn to him, I go, here we go. We miss, they get the ball, shoot, score, by 4. They get the ball, again, shoot, score, we're up by 2, timeout. Minute and a half to go. They come on the floor, they shoot and miss. Don Gizon gets the ball, outlets it to Julio, he comes down the floor, spots, follow, bounce pass, boom, score. They miss, we get the ball again, all right. Don Gizon, another rebound. Outlets to Michael Pendant, Pendant to Julio, Julio back to Pendant, wow, three-pointer from the three-point line. Make a long story short, folks, at the buzzer, Celtics 82, Houston Christian 70, provincial champion. The last thing I need to do, we didn't just come away with a championship, we also came away with some individual awards. It's very important, I think, that we recognize these three players. They're all winners, each and every one of them. I mean, Christopher Ranquino played a great 4 games. John Dizon just gave everything he had in every game. I mean, they all deserve something, but it's unfortunate. Okay, things won't work that way. Marvin Soriano would come in off the bench and hit a key jump shot, make a steal, make a big pass, and get them going again every time they stall. All right, but we don't pick them, we just accept them. So, to let you know how it all went, Michael Pendon was given an honorable mention. He shouldn't have been. He should have been at least a second All-Star or a first All-Star, but that's not the way it goes. He was an honorable mention, and we'll take it, okay? Carlos Santos. Could have just as easily have been the MVP. He wasn't, but he was a first team All-Star. We'll take that. All right, we're going to get it. And of course, the tournament MVP, the most valuable player. Hey, you can't argue. Where are you, Charlie? There he is. There's Absolutely. We have a Celtic weekend. How can you complain? All right. I've said probably more than enough. The last thing I'd like to say before I give this over to Nap is one of the reasons why they've been so successful is because of these two gentlemen right here who have given up so much of their time that Mr. Robles every now and then forgets what his wife's first name is. Because she's in the gym with Nat, all right? But these two have given up a lot of their time, sacrificed a lot of their time, and have been great role models for these students. And we've been very, very blessed to have them, and I know that they'll tell you the same thing. So they really do deserve a round of applause. I said my piece, I'm gonna hand this over to Coach Santos.
Hi, my name is Nap Santos, coach of the number one basketball team in the province. First of all, I'd like to share a little bit about myself and how I became a huge fan of basketball. It started when I was probably 5 years old and my dad loved basketball. We would shoot around for hours in our little driveway with one of those Nerf hoops. He would never let me win, and I would just hate that. But that brought out my competitiveness. He would take me to his games, and I would watch him and idolize the guys on the team. By the way, I used to idolize Julio's dad back in the day, but now I idolize Julio. Aww. I didn't play basketball on a team in elementary because there wasn't a team. So I decided to bowl. Yeah, that's 10 pin bowling. Having a Filipino father, once their basketball career is over, bowling was the way to go. So I joined bowling leagues, and believe it or not, I actually became a provincial champion in grade 8. And even though I bowled, I still had time to play basketball at local communities with friends. In grade 8, I actually didn't go to St. Pat's. I went to McRoberts High School. There were tryouts for the grade 8 basketball team, but I wasn't interested. Because in my mind, I was a great bowler. For some strange reason though, the grade 8 coach came up to me at lunchtime in the gym and asked me to try out. I guess he saw me shooting around or something. I told my parents about a tryout. They just told me to do whatever I wanted to do, whatever made me happy. I knew there were 2 or 3 tryouts left, but I actually just decided to go to the last one. Well, I killed it. I just remember shooting a lot and those shots were going in. So I made the team. We weren't a good team, but I love the fact that I was on a team. I decided to stop bowling and started playing more basketball. In grade 9, I came to St. Pat's and played on the junior team. Mr. Renzullo was my coach, and I thought he was the coolest guy in the world, and he still is. In grade 10, he gave me the green light to shoot from anywhere I wanted to. We had a really good team in grade 10, and I remember at the end of the year, he would give us stat sheets, and I averaged 20 points a game, and that was cool. In grade 11 and 12, I played for the senior team for Mr. Bill Anderson, and he was quite an intense person. In grade 11, I played in the finals of the single A's, and we lost. In grade 12, we went to the double A's, and I think we came in 10th. After high school, I pursued my basketball career in the Philippines. I played college there. I tried out for national teams and semi-pro. It was a great experience for me. Now with me being a Celtic, I went to St. Pat's Elementary in grade 1, 2, and 3, moved to Richmond, and in grade 4, I stayed in Richmond. I missed St. Pat's so much, I went back in grade 5. Then I missed Richmond so much, so I went back to Richmond in grade 6 and 7. In grade 8, I went to McRoberts, but I couldn't handle it there anymore, so I asked my parents if I could go to St. Pat's, and the rest is history. So I am a Celtic through and through. We should all be proud of this close-knit community because it is unique and like no other. I am proud to be a St. Pat's Celtic. I would like to thank the school administration, the staff, ex-staff, St. Pat's alumni for all their support, Mr. Bivakwa and Mr. Danici. Thank you for giving me this opportunity and for all your kind words to me. Mr. Grout, thank you for videotaping our games and giving us something to remember. Ms. I and Mrs. Rizzullo, thank you for putting a lot of pressure on me to win a blue banner. Thank you for all your support and your insight about how to become a champion. I wish he was here to Bill Anderson. Thank you for being the most intimidating coach in the world. You've taught me about hard work, dedication. You taught me no guts, no glory. You taught me how to yell and scream. You are my ideal coach. To Mr. Renzullo, I am so honored to have been a player for you. And now it's a privilege to be working with you. You always give me great advice when I call you about the senior boys basketball issues and once in a while life issues. You're the coolest guy in the world, and I appreciate everything you do for our St. Pat's community. I would like to thank all the fans for supporting this great team. Thank you for cheering them on and giving them the energy. You can clap for yourselves, that's for you guys. Thank you to the Wicks family who have been coming to our games even though their kids are no longer going to the school. We appreciate your support. I want to thank all the parents of the senior boys basketball team.
Thank you for your hard work and dedication, filling water bottles and taking
down stats. To my grade 10s, take everything you've learned from this experience and learn from it. You can only get better. To my grade 11s, now that you know what it takes to win a championship, don't be satisfied. Don't be satisfied. Expect more fruit from yourself and get better so you too can win a blue banner in your grade 12 year. To my grade 12s, thank you for a great season. The best ever. Thank you for all the times you stressed me out, but still at the end, you guys work hard. I hope you take everything you've learned from this experience and apply it to your life. I always talk about accountability and being responsible for your own actions. Remember that and apply that to everything you do in life. Keep working hard in whatever you do and never give up on your dreams. Believe you can do it. Trust yourself, trust God, and positive things will happen to you. You guys know what happened to me the last few years, and now I'm on top of the world. I have a beautiful family, a beautiful girlfriend, Arvin Ref, stop talking about her. Beautiful kids, and now I have a beautiful blue banner.
They're a close group, aren't they?
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. That's beautiful.
Patrick Russell.
Thank you. Defensively, there's no problems. We're getting our stops. We're just not finishing on the offensive end. And we're getting layups. We're getting some wide open shots. Everyone's helping each other. I see that. Everyone's helping each other. Gotta keep pressing, dig. Dig deep. Where is the ball?
Jackson Forsythe scoring first for the Irish.
What? Thank you.